Currently, Disney and Lucasfilm are focused on Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker, as well as a handful of live-action TV series for Disney+, and on top of all of that, the new Star Wars trilogy by the creators of Game of Thrones, David Benioff and D.B. Weiss. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you are new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, I don't know if you guys are aware about what just happened over at D23, but today, on August 23rd, the official Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series announcement took place on stage. Ewan McGregor was there. They gave us some details about the production of the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series. So in case you guys did not know, what's really interesting about all of this is that, of course, over at D23, we learned a handful of information about the Kenobi TV show for Disney+. So all scripts are apparently written already, and production is all set and ready to begin next year in 2020, and they're actually moving forward with a 2021 release. Now, that honestly is great because we do know that Disney+, they're also aiming for the Cassian Andor TV series to take place in 2021 as well. Now, if in case you guys are wondering about the timeline of the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series, it takes place roughly 8 years. 8 years after the events of Revenge of the Sith. And that's going to give us a different version of Obi-Wan Kenobi for sure. I can see why they would want to make it 8 years, because they're trying to create the bridge between Kenobi in A New Hope and Kenobi in Episode 3. So we're going to get that middle-aged version of Kenobi where he's not quite like how he looked as Alec Guinness portrayed him in Star Wars A New Hope and, of course, Empire and Return of the Jedi. Now, let me say, I think that this is a healthy thing for the Star Wars franchise, though I would have rather to have this in the form of an actual feature-length film that would actually be released into movie theaters, you know, where a lot of people would just go to the theater and watch it in the theater seats. But the great advantage about this is that with TV shows, I'm sure a lot of you guys already know this, is that with TV shows, you do get more character development because you can go episode by episode, and each and every episode is going to be 1 hour long in length. Now, I'm hoping that they at least go past one season for the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series, kind of like how they're treating Star Wars The Mandalorian, that already has gotten a season 2 already in the works, where this October they will actually be doing a lot of rewrites for season 2, or actually doing the writing of the script, I should say, and begin filming in early 2020 for that as well. So, the thing about the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series is that this definitely does line directly up with what we heard about 8 months ago. You guys may remember a very long time ago, the big rumors about them transferring some of the scripts from the actual movie itself to the actual TV show in the forms of episodes. So that does make a lot of sense as to why all the scripts are already done and pretty much moving forward, where production is all set and ready to begin in 2020. Now, we're not quite sure exactly if that means filming per se, but they are aiming for a 2021 release, and I can see why they're trying to do this. They're trying to remedy the gap between, of course, Episode 9 and the new Star Wars trilogy. So we have The Mandalorian this year, and then they're aiming for The Mandalorian Season 2 in 2020, with, of course, Cassian Andor and the Kenobi TV series in 2021, and then before you know it, 2022, we got the first film of the fourth Star Wars trilogy. So, honestly, I think it's a nice flow of things because we also have the Clone Wars Season 7 coming our way for Disney+. Now, this, of course, gives a lot of opportunities for the Kenobi TV series. You can have Darth Maul in there, you could have Darth Vader, you could even have Yoda's Force Ghost voice communicating with Kenobi and teaching him through the ways of the Force remotely. And heck, they could even throw in Liam Neeson if they really wanted to throw in the first live-action version of a Force Ghost of Qui-Gon Jinn, without a doubt. So, I would really love to hear what you all have to say about the Kenobi TV series, because, honestly, I am very excited the fact that they announced this at D23. We heard just a couple of days ago, you guys may have actually heard the big story, that there was a lot of talk that Ewan McGregor was actually signing on, and now it's official, guys. I mean, it's actually happening. This is the real deal, you know, it's all confirmed. They're actually moving forward with all of this. Ewan McGregor is back, and they are all sitting ready to also include new characters into the mix. Now, the only thing I will say is that I hope that they do stay true to his character, and they don't alter the character of Obi-Wan Kenobi. He has to stay pretty close to how he was portrayed by Ewan McGregor in Revenge of the Sith, while also kind of borrowing elements as to how Alec Guinness portrayed him in Star Wars A New Hope, in order to give us an authentic version of Obi-Wan Kenobi that a lot of fans are truly going to enjoy around the entire world. So yeah, guys, anyways, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content, for today. Do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.